What do all those rumors about limb technology leave us with? The most by far was that limb technology never existed. An elaborate yarn spun by opportunists to siphon government funds into their pockets. The demonstration from Dr. Ophelia Turner and President Koch was well within the ability of an amateur magician.
And once again, Dr. Turner's lack of accomplishments in her academic career is an easy portrait of a scientist eager for a win. That would slot Dr. Turner firmly in the myth camp. We may never be able to agree on what limb was, or if it even existed. But we can certainly understand why its existence was necessary.
The state of the world that existed needed to believe in something so fantastical. Here's my submission to the ever-growing theory pile. It is no coincidence that the year the zone was established was 1955.
That year also marked the start of the space race. For that next decade, there is no hotter topic, no singular focus of effort and funding than beating the Soviets. With Sputnik's launch in 1957, followed by Gagarin's first brush with space in 1961, America fell behind with every passing year. Its desperation only increased with the very public explosion of Project Vanguard, America's first satellite launch attempt. And then, to go from not being able to get off the launch pad to 6 years later, being the first to land a man on the moon, that is a whole lot of technological progress to make from a losing position. The timing of limb technology couldn't have been more perfect. The government springs into action, promoting limb while being simultaneously effusive and evasive, an American political specialty. The live demonstrations are few, the vagaries plenty, but there is a notable wave of professors vacating their spots at major universities to take on positions at ARDA. Some interesting fields of study from the bunch: experts in crop domestication, enclosed biological ecosystems, and radiobiology. Sounds like a child's tale.
We can take on a shape that fits cleanly with the race to the stars.
I will reiterate here, this is only my theory, but I dare say it's a good one.
Francis.
What, me?
The electrical grid is your department.
You know the plan as well as I do.
So you'd rather trust me than have to speak up for yourself? Guess you're on your own, driver. Good luck.
Okay, fine. The regular anchors aren't enough to overcharge the arc device to the level we need. But there's an old anomaly barricade we can piggyback onto. It's archaic technology, an early attempt to stop anomalies from drifting out into the wider Olympic Peninsula. It worked for some time.
Until it didn't.
But long enough to get the old wall built.
The barricade's in bad shape, but what's a little rampant voltage leakage? Not like the ghosts and goblins of the Deep Zone will mind. And if they do, all the better for Francis. Huh?
Appreciate the olive branch, Oppy, but boy, do you have a lot to learn about the paranormal. I'd be happy to give you a primer after all this is over.
Ugh, hard pass. I'm far too old for that.
The car will induce a current along the barricade, in the same way you did it crossing the old wall. Every connection point needs to be induced within a limited time. Electrify the entire barricade, and we'll have all the power we need.
You heard him. Floor it, driver.
You're near the barricade's operating station. Can you get in there and look around? We need something that'll give us the lay of the land.
Perfect. I'm uploading the barricade map to your ARC device. By my calculations, if you electrify all 8 posts, you'll have all the power you need. Oppie, does that seem right?
Does it seem right to you?
I think so. Yeah, I ran the numbers a few times, and I...
Then get to it, driver.
Working.
Making good time. Keep it up. Looking good, driver. Beep. Beep.
few more to go.
Charged. Arc device readings at 4.2 gigajoules and holding steady.
Good. Then we're all set. The arc device is ready to go. It'll hold that charge for as long as we need it.
Pedal to the metal, driver. Storm's coming.
Thank you. nice work out there. The whale could be a lot. Take your time and gear up. No telling what that remnant's going to unleash.
Hey, driver. I sent you something, if you don't mind taking a look. Is his favorite cryptid of them all. If it's not too much to ask, if you could put it on your dashboard so Tobias can come along for the ride, for wherever you're going. But don't feel obligated by any means.
Thank you.